What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach, Elliot Scott. And as you can see by the title below, we're going to talk about if a guy pulls away, and then, of course, he comes back, could it ever be the same? Now, if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Just click the red button below. I'll love you forever. Also, my texting guide, 180 plus pages of nothing but, you know, information on texting is out now. So if you want to get the link, it's in the description below. I'll probably put it in the comments also. Again, this is for girls who, you know, guys are pulling away through text. They're not initiating as much as they used to. You want to know what he's thinking during the text. You want to know what to text him. You want to get him to initiate and send you or ask for the date. Everything. Everything involving texting, building attraction over text, flirting over text. Again, he will never pull away again if you get this guide and you understand it and you master it. Of course, probably with my value guide too. That's a double whammy. You're literally getting the value guide, or if you get my value guide, you'll know how to create value and get him to think of you as a high value woman. And if you get my texting guide, you're basically not making any mistakes. So check out the texting guide if anything. The links are down below. So the guy pulls away and he realizes, well, who knows why he comes back. I was going to say he realizes it's not as good out there, so he returns. Could it be the same? Obviously, you know where I'm going to go with this. I think that it personally depends on why the guy pulled away, because there are great instances. I've been on both sides of it where, you know, I pulled away and then I realized I made a huge mistake and came back, you know, and then there's times where I pulled away, I missed her and I came back, and then there's times where I pulled away and then I realized, I want to go back, you know, with no intentions on dating, and I came back around. It all comes down to value. It all comes down to, are you building attraction? It all comes down to, are you showing off the best that you can show off, right? Guys date girls based on benefits. If it's chill, if it's fun, if it's casual, when he comes back, then actually, no, let's back up a little bit. I want to give you a little more intel or detail on this. Usually when a guy pulls away, you can't really blame the guy all the time. Women blame guys too much for all the problems in relationships. You know, they automatically assume that if a guy pulls away, he's an asshole. If a guy pulls away, he just wanted sex. If a guy pulls away, he's this, that. Maybe he's pulling away because he doesn't want a relationship with you because you're not doing a good job. You know, there's times where I dated women. I'm not saying there's not assholes out there. There is. But, you know, there's a lot of time. Let me just tell you, from talking to a lot of men and being a man myself, a majority of guys don't go out of their way to treat women like shit on purpose, to be assholes on purpose, okay? A lot of times they go in, they get to know the girl, they realize it's not what they want, and then he pulls away. That's what happens a lot of the times. Yes, there are guys out there who will tell women what they want to hear and things like that, and then manipulate them. But I would say for the most part, a majority of the time, a guy is just a typical guy trying to make it in the world just like a woman is. If he likes you, he probably won't treat you like shit. So don't worry about if he's pulling away or not, or if it's going to work or not. Just work on winning him over. Because when you have him, or at least before he pulls away, if he pulls away, you know, I don't want to pre-assume. But when you have the guy in your possession, and you guys are doing great, having fun, hanging out, and the pacing is correct. A lot of times guys pull away because of pacing and pressure, and women are like, oh, everything's going great, but then he pulled away all of a sudden. No, things were going great on the surface, like, you know, getting along, but he probably pulled away because it was moving too fast, too much pressure, too much this, too much that, and it kind of caught him off guard and freaked him out. But if you're doing things correctly when the guy is with you and he likes you, he's not going to do that to you. That's what women don't understand. You know, you have to create this atmosphere. If a guy likes you, he's more than likely not going to do that to you. So when a guy does pull away, it can be for 1,000 reasons, right? Maybe there is a family issue. Maybe it is a commitment issue. Maybe it is something with work, whatever. But then at the same time, maybe it's because he's taking you for granted and he wants to go out and look and then come back and see what else is out there, and then he realizes, oh, it's not what I thought it was, and then he comes back. And when he comes back, maybe he realizes you were the shit. You know, he just had to be reminded of it. But then of course, like I said, there's guys out there who are just big pieces of shit and will go out or hit you not hit you, hit it, and then, you know, go out, do his thing, and then come back because he knows you'll take him back, right? And he's just using you for that. But like I said, that is the wrong way to look at it. For the most part, the way I would look at it is, am I attracting him? Am I creating this? Hold on, I got to dismiss. I got an alarm. There you go. Am I creating the correct atmosphere for growth? Again, that is the way you have to look at it. If you're creating the right atmosphere for attraction, if you're creating the right atmosphere for growth, for a relationship, for having fun, hanging out, building rapport, and having everything go correctly, he's going to like you, things are going to work out, and he's going to be less likely to pull away. But to answer the question, if he comes back, is it always going to be different? No. Could it be the same? Yes. Can you make things great? I think you can. It all just depends on the atmosphere you're creating. So with that being said, ladies, if you haven't yet, again, subscribe. And my new guide is out. The link is below. I love you forever. Take care and peace.